Welcome back to my YouTube channel. And after a long time today, I opened my laptop that I used to make the videos. After a long time, I just reinstalled everything and refreshed my laptop. So what happened? Everything went well. All the things were installed and the SQL Server I found. So I thought I'd make a video on that. So what is the issue? Maybe you guys can have the same thing. This is the Microsoft SQL Server 2022. The version is this, but when I'm connecting, it's simply installed. I just follow the simple step, and when it installed, the system admin user was not there. Even I cannot log in from this SQL Server authentication, because while installing, maybe I skipped, or maybe you would have the same situation. This Windows authentication is fine, but I didn't get any kind of, like, I didn't create this, that is system admin or this enable this SQL Server authentication. So I'm going to do that in the video. So I thought I'd record it and we'll upload it, inshallah. So let's resolve this issue. So how are we going to resolve this issue in a minimal time? So these are the three steps that we have to follow. Number one, we have to go to enable the SQL Server authentication. So we'll go to this, and in the Object Explorer, we'll find this instance, and we'll just right click and go to the properties. In the properties, we will see these, there's option select a page. We'll select this security. From there, we will select this SQL Server authentication mode. Once we select this, we have to click on the OK, and it will give us a message. Some of the configuration change will not take effect until SQL Server is restarted. So we have to restart the service. So our second step is to restart the SQL Server service. For that, we will just click on the OK, and I'll just close this instance, and we'll press SSMS. Oh, sorry. Services.msc. This we'll go to this services, and here we'll find a SQL Server services. We'll restart it. First, I make sure I close the instance of my SQL Server, and here there's a restart option. I'll restart this SQL Server service for the safe side, also starting this agent as well, and all the other services. So refresh. Okay, maybe the things are fine. Okay, this basically this service we need to restart. So I'm done with this. Okay, it's it already been restarted. So the next step is that now create the SA user. So we are going to proceed with the last step. So under this we have a security and logins. We'll click on this login, and we'll add a new login here. Okay, so this is the login name, and we'll click on this SQL Server authentication. The login name will be SA, and whatever user you want to make, and I will name it. I will give my password. Whatever you want to set, you can do. Okay, and default database is master, default language, let it be, don't touch it for now. And there's the server roles, whatever we want to give them, the server roles, public, system admin, and whatever you want, bulk admin I want to give. So for now, system admin is enough, and this, so it depends on your choice, whatever you want to, maybe for your case, this would be enough, and it depends case to case. Now user mapping will go. Okay, everything is fine. Securable status. Okay, grant and enabled. Now I'll click OK. Okay, so I got some error. Maybe some of the mistakes were done, but when I rechecked, so what you have to make sure, you have to provide the login name properly, your password, and I also do this info password expiration. And in the server roles, I selected the system admin, user mapping, I selected all the database, and this is DB owner and public. Both I have given, and status, it should be grant permission to connect the database engine, and login should be enabled. Okay, and then we'll click on the OK, and then we'll working. You see the SA user is being created. And now when I'll try to create, and for this connection security, for now, let's make it optional and select this. This may my username, and I give this a BCD123 getting because of this mandatory, make it this optional. Okay, so inshallah I will not be getting this now. See, because this is the new extended functionality, I have not checked it yet, but we'll see this now. Click you have to provide the new password name. So my previous one was something else, now I am going to change it. Now you see successfully I connected with this SA user. So that's all. So we successfully created the system admin user. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. I see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.